Thank you. When you offered Mr. Mueller the opportunity to review or edit, I'm not exactly sure what your characterization was, your 3.5-page summary of his report, and he declined, did he give you a reason why he declined?
I didn't talk to him directly.
Were you provided with a reason why the Mueller team did not want to participate?
I don't recall whether a reason was given.
So somebody offered to them that they could review your summary, make comments.
It wasn't a summary. It was a statement of the principal conclusions. It wasn't a summary of the report.
Okay. Your 3.5-page letter, did you take it that there was no reason given back for their declining to do so?
Did I what?
Did you take it that there was no reason for them to do so? In other words, did they not tell you in any way, shape, or form why they declined to participate in reviewing your 3.5-page letter?
I don't recall whether that was related to me. My sense was that he understood that this was the function of the Attorney General. I'm the person to whom the report's given.
Okay. You know, I'm listening to you on the Mueller report, and here's my problem. You say in your March 24th letter that you are mindful of the public interest on this matter and that you will release as much of the report as you can consistent with applicable law, regulations, and department policies. You follow up with a letter of a few days later outlining four categories in which you are evaluating redactions. One of those categories is grand jury related to Federal Rule of Civil Criminal Procedure 6E. The other three are intelligence, ongoing prosecutions, and privacy reputational interests. And I ask you, what is the authority for that? And you track it back to department policies, which do not have the force of law.
They do when they're embodied in regulation.
The regulation
states
triggers back to department policies,
right,
which are...
The regulation states that any disclosure has to be in accord with those policies.
Do you consider
that
you have...
It's a regulatory mandate.
Do you consider that you have the discretion as to how you apply those department policies?
I have discretion.
Okay. And so we're sitting here, from my perspective, with virtually unlimited discretion for you to redact from that document. And maybe if I trusted my government more, I would be comfortable with that. But since I don't, I'm not comfortable with that. And I'm looking for some way in which your judgment, which is going to be the arbiter, as I understand it, of what the public sees, the arbiter, it's you, ultimately, can be overseen. I've suggested to you that under 6E, there are procedures under which you can go to court to ask the court to give you guidance, direction, or an order. I'm not sure whether you will do that or not.
Well, a court is limited to the grounds stated in 6E.
This is correct. But you do have quite a bit of discretion to go to court under 6E if you review it. So that's one category. The other category, obviously, is that there would be some function for Congress to exercise in its oversight responsibility under the Constitution, but I am not clear as I sit here today whether you envision a role for Congress in that oversight.
Well, I think I sort of addressed that. I identified the four categories, and the team that includes the special counsel office lawyers are implementing that.
Can you?
So, they are the ones redacting what is 6E. They're the ones who conducted the investigation. They know what is 6E and what is not 6E. That's why I'm dependent on the special counsel to identify 6E. And the intelligence community will identify the intelligence stuff.
Do you
and the lawyers who were prosecuting the cases and the special counsel's office can identify whether there's going to be a conflict between releasing any information and a court order or an ongoing prosecution. And the special counsel's office knows who the peripheral players are that they've said shouldn't be charged. So those are the categories.
Does Congress have a role in overseeing your decision as to what is and isn't taken out of the Mueller report? Is there any circumstances under which any member of Congress would have full access to all of the Mueller report, period, maybe under conditions, but is there any circumstance you can envision, sir, where Congress, with whatever protective procedures may be in place, would have access to the full report to review it?
Yes, I did say here that once that report is ready for release, I would not only give it to the chairman of the judiciary committees, but I would talk to them and engage with them about what additional information they feel they require and whether there's a way of accommodating that.
They have to give you a reason. What if they just want to see the report to satisfy themselves of your exercise of discretion?
Well, it depends. Take classified information. I can envision.
You have an intelligence committee for that.
If you let me finish, I was saying I can envision a situation where under appropriate safeguards, that information would be shared. I also think there may be, under appropriate safeguards, a way of people verifying that these categories were not abused and that the information is bona fide privacy-related information and so forth. And I'm willing to work with the judiciary committees on that. But I'll have to say that until someone shows me a provision in 6E that permits its release, Congress doesn't get 6E unless there is a provision that permits it.
There's plenty of discretion in 6E for you to make that judgment.
Where would you find that?
Judicial proceedings, akin to judicial proceedings, if you want to go there. I'm sorry, I'm really out of time, but there are a number of interpretations you can make of 6E that would give you some pretty good discretion to come up to Congress under limited circumstances, possibly, to be able to satisfy somebody in Congress who gets to see the entire report and who gets to oversee you.